Goal number three is called good health and well-being. The goal three logo represents a trace of an electrocardiogram that ends with an heart. Important steps have been taken to improve life expectancy and reduce infant and maternal mortality diseases. In Africa, between 2000 and 2016, the number of children dying under the age of 5 was reduced to almost half. Poor children are the ones most exposed to this risk. The third objective is to reduce the mortality of these children, but not only that. Another objective is to reduce maternal mortality. They are often young girls between the age of 15 and 19. To contain diseases such as AIDS and malaria, access to clean water and sanitation had to be facilitated. Objective three seeks to reach as many people as possible with medicines and vaccines. These are goal three targets. 3.1, by 2030, reduce the overall maternal mortality rate to less than 70 per 100 live births. 3.2, by 2030, put an end to avoidable deaths of infants and children under the age of 5 with the aim of reducing neonatal mortality in all countries to no more than 12 per 1,000 live births, and for children under the age of 5, reduce mortality to no more than 25 per 1,000 live births. 3.3, by 2030, and the epidemics of AIDS, tuberculosis, malaria, and neglected tropical diseases, and fight hepatitis diseases related to water use and other communicable diseases. 3.4, by 2030, reduce premature mortality from non-communicable diseases by one-third through prevention and treatment, and promote mental health and well-being. 3.5, strengthen prevention and treatment of substance abuse, including drug abuse and harmful alcohol use. 3.6, by 2020, halve the number of deaths worldwide and road accident injuries. 3.7, by 2030, ensure universal access to sexual and reproductive health care services, including those for family planning, information and education, and the integration of reproductive health into national strategies and programs. 3.8, achieve universal health coverage, including protection from financial risks, access to essential quality health care services, and access to safe, effective quality and affordable essential medicines and vaccines for all. 3.9, by 2030, substantially reduce the number of deaths and diseases from hazardous chemicals and pollution and contamination of air, water, and soil. 3.10, strengthen implementation of the framework convention of the World Health Organization on tobacco control in all countries as appropriate. 3.b, to support research into and development of vaccines and drugs for communicable and non-communicable diseases, particularly in developing countries, and to provide access to essential medicines and affordable vaccines. In accordance with the Doha Declaration on TRIPS and public health, which affirms the right of developing countries to make full use of the provisions of the agreement on the trade aspects of intellectual property rights, on flexibility to protect public health, and in particular to provide access to medicines for all. 3.c, substantially increase the financing of healthcare and recruitment, development, training, and maintenance of health workers in developing countries, especially in less developed countries and small island developing states. 3.d, strengthen the capacity of all countries, in particular developing countries, for the prevention, reduction, and management of national and global health risks. The money from state taxes paid by tourism agencies that can be invested to solve this emergency. Taxes paid by tourists can also help improve health services. Tourists themselves can make life better for these children and young women by avoiding sex tourism.